Here we go for round four of the OGRL iRacing Championship. We move on to round number one of the Oval Racing Series with the legends here at Charlotte tonight. We've got an 11-car grid for the final. Cameron Willissey is on pole in 43 following his heat win, alongside Connor Gibson Leach in 42, the winner of heat number two. Row two is 259 Aaron Tressler and 447 Adam Turner. Row three, 93 Kane van der Bosch and number five, Paul Broderick. Row 4, 14, Carl Wincop, 83, Ben Singleton. Row 5, 53, Nigel Foster and 36, Roy Anderson. And row 6 on his own will be Kane Twigg in number 3. Unfortunately, the 12-car James Eccles will be a non-starter after problems in his heat race. So, two rolling laps. The first one is just drawing to its conclusion. We're going to go one to go to the green this time, and then we go Legends Car Racing once again here at Charlotte. Field make their way into turn three and four. The pace car pulls off, leading them to their own fruition. The leader is Cameron Willissey on the start. He will more or less decide when we go. Green flag goes down, we're away and racing with tonight's Legends final. Tressler gets to jump through for second place. Oh, Gibson Leach has been tagged by Turner. Van der Bosch is clouded in. So has the five of Broderick. Oh, Big Ken have got a rollover as Kean Twigg goes up. And then another one on the centre as Foster goes rolling off the side of the Goodrich car. Kean Van der Bosch in 93. Yellow flag straight away on the first bend of the final. Now, in the heats, we got only one stoppage per heat. There is Connor Gibson Leach heading straight for the nearest body shop and probably straight for the nearest alignment area as well, as the front wheel, the front left wheel anyway, that car is looking somewhat out of line. Meantime, our leader is Cameron Willissey in the 43 car. He managed to avoid the first bend carnage off pole position. Tressler jumps through for second on the start, as we saw. He got past Gibson Leach on the first bend. That was very fortuitous for Tressler, as he managed to avoid all the carnage that ensued behind. Carl Wincop got through for third place by the looks of it in the 14 car. To the signal having to be put back into a lower position, as he in fact managed to gain a couple of places under yellow flag conditions. The S36 Rowanderson in the Quaker State sponsored car, very smart livery on that machine. There's been an update as well to the grid under the yellow flag period. Car 5, Paul Broderick, was in fact third place when the yellows came out. So 14 goes down to 4th, and 83 is 5th in the Stars and Stripes. There's Adam Turner in 447 rejoining us from the pits. He clearly had some problems after being clouted on the original start. He collected Connor Gibson Leach on the first bend, and then Van der Bosch had nowhere to go and T-boned the side of Adam Turner. So Willissey will lead the way on the restart when we get the restart, with Tressler chasing him down in 259. Paul Broderick has made a good start in the number 5 car. He started 6th on the grid. He's climbed 3 places in the first lap, mainly thanks to everyone in front of him having their own accident in their own time. So he just managed to avoid all the carnage. It's a single file restart. The pace car lights are out, which means you are going to go green this time. There goes the pace car off into the pits. Tressler trying to preempt the start here, ducking and weaving all over the place, trying to put Cameron off, but I don't think that's going to work. It certainly hasn't. The green flag goes down, and Willissey gets a great start from the front. Broderick is under immediate pressure though from Wincop in 14. Anderson in 36 has now got Van der Bosch sneaking around outside. A3 Singleton goes for an almighty tank slapper going round turn two. Just keeps it out of the wall so it can continue, but has lost a good number of places on that restart. Anderson now goes sideways. He gets clouted by 93 Van der Bosch. That bunch of Gibson Leach has 5 of Broderick and 14 Wincop come together down here on the home straight. They both live to tell the tale, but they very nearly didn't. Willissey and Tressler are broken free. Then Turner and Gibson Leach have got some ground to make up in 42 and 447 after they both had to make pit stops for damage under that first yellow flag period of the race. Hopefully the only yellow flag period of this race. As I say, only had one yellow flag per heat race. We managed to get nearly to the end in heat one before the yellows were thrown, leaving us with a one lap dash to the finish. Winkop in 14 runs wide. Here comes Van der Bosch down the inside. Doesn't need asking twice, does he? Absolutely not, is the answer. And down the inside comes the Goodrich, the Dale Earnhardt sort of tribute car, if you like. And he goes through into the position. So that's Van der Bosch now up into fourth place. Gibson, Leach and Turner at the moment are a lap down. If there is another yellow flag, they will get the wave around. We didn't do a wave around for the first caution period. You so many cars diving in the pit lane. It's a bit difficult to police what was lapped down and what wasn't. Wincott runs wide. Gibson Leach comes looking down the inside in 42 as well. And Gibson will probably make a way through. He will indeed do so. Wincott probably not too bothered about that as they're not fighting position. Van der Bosch meantime goes for third and gets third, more to the point, as he gets past Broderick in the number five car. Gibson has been taken back by Wincott, but of course they're not on the same lap as each other, so it really matters not about that position change. Ray Anderson in 36, I think, is the next car in line after Wincott on the road. The 36 car, that's position-wise anyway, on the road. It is still the Gibson, Leach and Turner battle. But as we say, they're a lap down on proceedings. Turner, I think, might very well be two laps down in proceedings. So they make their way round this Charlotte quarter mile oval down here. Screaming very nicely indeed, these legends. They make an awesome soundtrack, these motorcycle engine machines. 1250cc engines in them. Gibson Leach has certainly got the pace to compete with Carl Wincott, but the problem is being a lap down, and Gibson's going to go around on turn four. Oh dear, commentator's curse strikes again. Connor Gibson Leach goes spinning, and that has in fact prompted yellow flag number two. So wage is coming out for Connor Gibson Leach, having his spin down here on the home straight. Now that's rather good luck for Connor, because him and Adam will now get a wave around to the back of the grid so they can get their lap back. There's Renderson, the Quaker State 36 car. So with the yellow flags coming out, the race is once again going to be neutralised. Roy Anderson is running in sixth position at the moment in the Quaker State car, but there's our top two. Willis C from Trester still the call of order. Van der Bosch has climbed up to third in that stint under green. That's dropped Broderick down into fourth in the number five car. Pace car lights on, so not going green this time. There's Adam Turner taking one of his laps back. As I say, I think he's got two laps to make up due to the fact he was in the pits a little bit longer than Connor was under the first caution period. Now, what a top three that is. Willisy, Trestler, Van den Bosch. This could be an explosive restart at the front. These three always able to give each other a challenge in stock cars. Will the same be said for the legends? We'll find out very shortly, of course, when we get clearance. We've got Connor Gibson Leach making one of his laps back as well in 42. Then Adam Turner as well making his second lap back in the 447 M&M's car. So they make their way round. They get past the pace car. And we should be going green very shortly. We just need to get those two to form up at the back of the grid. And once we've done that, I'm sure the pace car will extinguish the lights. And we can get racing once again in tonight's Legends Grand Final. So all the cars you see there, they are in the order they are in. They're all on the same lap again now, so it's more of a level playing field once again. We've lost a few cars. Nigel Foster, I note, has retired. So is Kean Twiggan, surprisingly, following their rollovers on the first bend. So just waiting to see. Yep, the pace car lights have gone out, which means we're going to go green this time. Kevin Van der Bosch looks to be already limbering up to try and pounce on the start. Cameron Willis, he so far has been very well at the restart. He did a brilliant restart earlier on in this race, plus a brilliant restart in his heat earlier on when he had that one lap dash to fend off from the chasing pack. Okay, green flag goes back out, and away go the legends once more. Willis, he gets the restart he wants. Trestler and Van der Bosch unable to pounce on the restart. Everyone else is now cleanly round turn one. No early exchanges, so everyone keeps it nice and single file so far. Broderick has dropped a little bit off the top three. as Wincop is seeing some attention from 36 Anderson. That could get lively. Gibson Leach also trying to give 83 Singleton something to think about behind them. Turner, not too far adrift either in 447. Down the back straight to turn three goes the battle towards the rear of the field. I think there's only nine cars left out in this, so this is the battle for seventh place. We're focusing on the Stars and Stripes liveried car of Ben Singleton heads that battle, followed by 42 Gibson Leach and then 447 Turner from the back. Very rare to see Adam at the back of a race at this stage. Oh, Wincup goes around on turn four. Same accident as Connor Gibson Leach earlier on. Now, has that brought the yellow flag out? He rejoins very quickly, and unfortunately, the yellow flags throw once again. So, race neutralised once more. The pace car will pick our leader up, who is still 43, Cameron Willissey. Everyone else slows it down, single file. Single file restarts, as you've already seen, is the call of order today for the Legends. Not the double file restarts. It may be somewhat a blessing in disguise going for the single file restarts, because we know from NASCAR, if you go double file restarts, it's often a case of cautions breed cautions. Today, so far, we're not seeing that problem. There's not having any first bend problems. It's issues that are a fair way into the stints. The order, with the exclusion of Kyle Wincup spinning out, has remained unchanged. Wincup goes to the back. Other than that, everyone else has remained in the same position they were in. Obviously, any cars behind Kyle will have moved position as they managed to overtake him whilst he was pointing the wrong direction down here on turn four. So everyone just keeping it a nice steady pace so far. This is how things need to be under yellow flag conditions. We do our best to get racing back underway as soon as we can. We want to give the drivers as much track time as possible and as many laps as possible at racing speed. Each driver today has had a 10-minute qualifying session, a 10-minute heat, and this 15-minute final. The field is split in half for the two heats. We had two heats of six cars, and then all of them came together for what we were expecting to be a 12-car final. But obviously, as I said, James Eccles a non-starter in number 12. So it put us down to 11 for tonight's meeting final. But thankfully, it hasn't affected the race too badly, having one car going missing. Drivers warming their tyres up as they go down the back straight, which would normally be the pit lane of the road course and the bigger super speedway oval here at Charlotte. Today, we're not using the big super speedway. We're using this little quarter mile infield oval for the Legends. The perfect size for them, very similar to what they would race on in the UK. Pace car lights in the meantime have been extinguished once again, which means the restart is imminent. The top three bunching right up, Broderick also bunching up, maybe looking to go around the outside on the restart. We're about to find out what happens though as we come back to go. Green flag racing in tonight's Legends Grand Final. Okay, green flag back down, away they thunder. So Willissey once again gets 3 seconds. Anderson straight to the outside of Broderick at turn one in 36. Can't make the move stick and has to fall back in line. Willissey still leads then 43. The regular two, the top road racer up at Lochgelly Raceway in Scotland. Had a bit of an incident last week with the curb at Lochgelly where the car launched onto two wheels over the curb. Very rare to see a hot rod end up going skywards, but it does happen occasionally. Chester in 259 runs in second. His uncle Gary, I believe, normally racing the Heritage Formula One stock cars at places like Brampton and Scunthorpe these days, with, I believe it was the Darkey Wright replica car for a few years. I don't know whether that one is still in the hands of the Chester family or not at this current point in time. Knight of the Van der Bosch runs in third. Anyway, Turner making a move around the outside of Gibson Leach in 42. This is going to be a great move around the outside for seventh. Can he make the move stick? Well, it's a long way around the outside here at Charlotte, but I think Adam's going to do it. Yes, he will. And Turner goes through into seventh place. His next target is the Stars and Stripes liveried car of 83, Ben Singleton, as they storm down the home straight at a rapid rate of knots. Really very quick machinery in this one. The Legends little pocket rockets. Their power to weight ratio is very good indeed. They weigh almost nothing, of course, and plonk a big motorcycle engine in the front of them. you're in for a recipe for a car that is very quick in a straight line and probably not that bad in the corners either, because they run some pretty grippy tyres. They're not slick tyres in Legends, but they are treaded, but not treaded a huge amount. Turner in 447 gets the nose chopped off there going into turn 3 from Singleton 83. They're catching the Broderick and Anderson battle ahead of them. That is over the fourth position between 5 and 36. Turner really hassling around the outside now, getting oh so close to that back straight wall, which has caught a couple of cars out today. We saw at the end of Heat 2, Roy Anderson have a rollover on the far side. Thankfully, he did finish the race in fifth place, the demise of Kieran Twigg on lap 2 of Heat number 2. Turner going around the outside, what a move this could be, into turn 3, and he's done it under braking. So Adam Turner goes through and takes sixth place away. Roy Anderson, next target in the Quaker State machine. Can he do anything about him? He's already up on the outside. This is a great drive from Adam Turner. Round the outside, like Roy Anderson was almost stood still there, side by side to turn 3. But Turner's got the move done already. Gibson Leach now trying to go around the outside of Singleton further back. And Wincup goes down the inside of Gibson Leach. So Connor's race is not going all that well in this one. He had a brilliant heat. He's managed to hold it round the outside of Carl Wincup for now. But Wincup is still on the inside, but has to fall back in line, accepting that he can't quite get a run on the inside line. Singleton has a bit of there coming out of turn number 4. Anderson is trying to catch back up to Turner. He's been delayed behind Broderick in number 5. Gibson trying that outer line again. But once again, as we can see, it isn't quite coming off. Turner so far, the one that's only really got the speed to do it. Singleton gets a bit cross, but again, rollover, and Turner's gone over on the last lap. The last lap flag is out as Broderick has spun around on the home straight. They rejoin and hit each other for a second time on the rejoin. Oh, dearie me. Gibson Leach has also had a battle with Singleton on the far side. Gibson Leach, as we say, that has gone. Cameron Willissey takes the checkered flag in 43, I should point out as well. So Willissey wins it. Second was Tress, the third Van den Bosch. Fourth went to Anderson. Fifth went to Carl Wincup, getting past the exchange between Singleton and Gibson Leach on the very last bend. Well, goodness me, what a dramatic end to the Legends final. Two incidents in the last lap. And there is our race. Power sliding out the bend. 43, Cameron Willissey.